esteemed very, very special guest in the studio with us. But before we go there, I'm going to give a shout out to everybody who's donated so far. If you want to donate, you can go to the link right down there at the bottom of the screen. It's YMU.life/give-for-Miami-Dade. And now I have with us a very special guest. She is the chair of the YMU Community Board, and it's my pleasure to welcome her today. Please welcome Shari Gurkin.
Thank you so much for having me here. It's a great day.
So I want to start out by asking how you got involved in YMU, because I hear you know one of our founders.
Yes, I am married now to Shari Gonzalez, the founder, but I was interested in YMU before I had even met Sony. I moved from New York about 2.5 years ago and was involved in a school in Harlem in New York and provided mentorship for the students there. So when I moved here, I was looking for a local organization that was offering programming and mentorship to students. So a friend reached out to me and said, you should meet Sammy Gonzalez and learn about YMU because I think that you would be very interested in the impact that they're making in the community. Mm-hmm. And that's where it all started.
Awesome.
I've been involved since then.
And has kind of philanthropy and community work always been something that you've been involved in, or is this a more recent thing for you?
I have always been pretty heavily involved in the community, probably from a young age in Miami. Mm-hmm. And when I moved to New York as well, I was involved. And moving back, I really see the growth of philanthropy in Miami. Mm-hmm. And especially something like this nonprofit, it's moving and shaking. It's really incredible to see what's going on.
And did you have a background in music? Was music something that you were drawn to as a musician, or was it as a consumer of music? How has music played a role in your life?
I do not have a background in music, but I love music. I love listening to music, watching performers, but actually since being a part of the YMU community and family, I've grown a deep appreciation for the musicians. Seeing the students performing behind the scenes and their journey for practicing for their performances, and it's truly incredible to watch.
Are you a live events kind of person? Do you enjoy going out, seeing shows, participating in events, cultural events around the city?
Yes, around the city for sure. The last live show I saw actually wasn't in Miami, it was in Arkansas at a music festival.
Okay, who'd you see?
There was a ton of performances, but my favorite was Flaming Lips, because they're great performers,
yeah.
And they're so much fun to watch.
It seems like an amazing live show, like the whole set and the whole thing.
Yeah. It was great. It was very intimate. It was cool.
Awesome. And have you, you've been to a number of YMU events. Do you have a favorite that you've gone to so far?
I've been to a ton of YMU events, for sure. I mean, you guys have around 100 a year or more.
Yeah, at this point it looks like well over 100 in our calendar for this year.
I love going to the Heat games and seeing them perform in the halftime show. They're so fun to watch, you know, running around and have all this energy, which is cool. And I love the annual gala performances. I mean, they come a year for that, so it's really amazing to watch them.
Yeah, and it's coming up on April 29th this year. I believe tickets are going to be released in February, so if you guys aren't on our email list, go to youngmusiciansunite.org, go right down to the bottom of the screen, sign up for our email list. So, Sarah, you are the chair of the YMU Community Board, and having a community board is a new thing for YMU. We've had a board of directors for a while that have kind of helped shape the direction and the vision of YMU, but have also played a big role leveraging their resources and relationships in the community. And so I'm wondering, from your perspective, what is the purpose of forming this board? What do you hope to accomplish? And take us through some of the steps that you've taken so far.
Sure. So the board was sort of conceived through a group of my friends who wanted to get involved in YMU. And there are many ways to get involved, but their kind of bread and butter is hosting events. Mm-hmm. So my friends and I love hosting events around the community. So we decided, why not host events and also put that towards raising money and awareness for an incredible cause and for these kids. And on top of that, having them perform at the events. So it's really about going out to the community and putting on fun activities, interactive experiences for people to come and enjoy and also listen to great music.
Awesome. So the mission around the community board is really focused on engaging the community and pulling our students out, making them part of the community, and bridging that gap. And you said fun events. So what can we be looking forward to? Is there something in the calendar already?
Yes. Well, we had our first event October 26th, which was a tennis and pickleball social. Very successful. We had the event at the Miami Beach Tennis Academy on 72nd and Collins, and we had about 65 people come and participate, and we had a silent auction. We raised over $5,000 for YMU, raising a ton of awareness. And our next event is January 28th. It's a health and wellness event. So we'll have yoga classes, art classes, juices, and performances by the Jazz Collective and other awesome YMU students. And it's just going to be a day all about taking a step back, relaxing, enjoying music. And we're very excited for it. We've been planning it for a while.
Awesome. Very cool. And so if you guys want to find out more about that event, we actually have a page up on our website. You can go to ymu.life/wellness, and you can check out all of the details for that January 28th wellness event. Sarah, I guess I just have two more questions for you as we wrap up. One is, I know you grew up here in Miami, then you moved to New York, and then you moved back to Miami. How has it been seeing Miami, knowing how Miami used to be when you were growing up here, seeing it how it is now, but also having that experience of maybe getting to participate in some of the cultural experiences that New York has to offer? So where does Miami sit, not in comparison, but where does it sit in its journey? Where do you see it kind of coming from? Where do you see it going? What are you excited about here in town?
Well, in terms of music specifically, growing up in down south in Miami, I didn't know much about the music education programming that was going on in public schools, and also just the students around me. We didn't really have these bands going on like they do now. So when I moved back and I was immersed in this whole world of music, it just excited me because that's something I love about New York, right? Going to performances and concerts and seeing these young emerging artists in New York taking chances. And I'm seeing that a lot more here now. It's becoming this hub of arts and culture and music. And it's really because a lot of these nonprofits are supporting the youth and the arts. And it's so important because that's the way that they're expressing themselves and gaining confidence and making friends from all over the city. And it's really bringing everyone together.
The last thing I want to talk to you about today is the event that you hinted at earlier. The kids work all year for that's April 29th. That's a big gala. Tickets, again, will go on sale for that in February, so stay tuned for that. But can you just tell our audience, what is that event like? What can they expect if they are one of the ones that's going to snap up one of those tickets before they sell out?
Sure. I've gone for the past 2 years, and I've brought around 40 people now because everyone's dying to come to this event. I've had friends fly in for this event. It is so much fun. I mean, it's like a rock concert with these kids who are on professional level, and we dress up in rock clothes and we just party all night, and it's just an incredible night.
Awesome. Well, Shari, I really appreciate being here today. Thank you for the work that you're doing with the community.